morning, you're welcome to your daily program, Street Vibes by VJSados. And don't forget that this program is powered by AK Samtech. This program is all about what is going on online, the viral things on the internet, what is going on in our environment. And today's episode, we'll be discussing on the issue of the news editor we have from Adamawa North Central, Senator Elisha Abbo. The issue of him, what he did to a lady, he slapped a lady in a supermarket, and this has been something people have been talking about, that this is, he is against the law of Nigeria. So I have a youth here with me, and we have been discussing about this new politics that we want youth. Now we have a youth. And some youths are saying that this is a disappointment from this man called Senator Elisha Abbo. So we have a youth here. So this issue of Senator Elisha Abbo, being a youth among the senator from Adamawa North Central, what do you see to the issue of what he did to the ladies?
Well, good day, viewers at home. I will say that what he did is nothing to write home about. It's like a Yoruba adage. It says someone you want to kill. But that same person went to rub kerosene all over his body. He now went close to fire. The older generations, they don't want to hand us this power. That's why for so many times now we have been clamoring for not too young to run.
Yes, of course.
But they gave us now, look at what he did.
Okay.
It's like he used what he did to like delay what so many people has worked for over time. What he did is nothing to write home about.
Are you saying what he did is wrong or right?
Sure, what he did is wrong.
Okay.
Is wrong. Aside the fact that he's a leader, you should not even look at the other side. He's a leader. A leader is not supposed to do something like that.
Okay.
Talk less of you laying hands on a fellow citizen.
Okay.
There are so many people clamoring for feminism, everything, okay, everything like that. But he has gone too far. And yes, a citizen, now, how will you feel if I just meet you somewhere and I start harassing you? That's harassment at the highest order.
Right.
So as a leader, he's not supposed to do something like that, because so many people are looking up to him. And minus, so many people are looking up to him. He's a young leader that is supposed to set precedence for how young people should rule in this country.
All right, thank you very much, my guest. I still have a question for you. So now, what he did? We have some media that have been questioning him, that what is the major reason why he did such? And to what he said he has no reason, and he is not ready to disclose it to anybody. What do you say to that?
Well, I would say that's actually a lie that I cannot subscribe to. How will I just meet you somewhere and I'll start beating you, and you tell me that you just beat me for no reason? No, there should be something that has happened. Even no matter what has happened, sometimes you don't have to look at the reason why people do some things.
Okay.
But when the punishment has gone beyond the offense, I don't want to think about anything that the woman might do. The woman is a nursing mother, for crying out loud.
Of course.
She's a nursing mother. And for him to lay hands on him, no matter what he has done, it's something that you can settle with word of mouth. He did it, I did this. And even at the extreme, let's say now shout on each other. Why did you do this? That one is still acceptable. But to the extent of beating someone, no matter what the reason might be.
Alright. Let me ask this question. What is your judgment to this? What is your judgment? Because we heard that Remy Tinubu, who is also a colleague, was like saying that should they give him should they support him or to give him a suspension? Should you get? But in the moment saying that, there was a a statement that was going on between them that the man was out, was saying that, was trying to tell you that Remi Tinubu should not even disrespect him because they are all colleagues. Yeah. So what do you want to say on this?
Well, just like the senator said, Senator Elisha Abbo, he said the case is already in court.
Yes.
That's what he said. He said the case is already in court, so nobody should. To me, they used to say something that before some things will stop, you have to make people as scapegoats. Yes, yes.
All right,
yes. This is a country that has constitution, a country that has rule guiding it. And there is a saying that where there is no law,
there is no sin.
But where there is law, there is sin. Where there is. So he will serve as example for other people. He is punished. I'm not the judge, I'm not the jury, I don't know the type of judgment that they will. But he shouldn't.
Alright, thank you very much, my dear brother. Yeah. So your name to the world.
Okay, my name is Oyewole Ibukun.
Thank you very much, viewers. You've heard so much on what he said on the issue of Senator Elisha Abbo. Now we've been saying that the new politics outside is that not too young to rule. So to the issue, so I'll be expecting your own comments. Thank you very much for watching this episode. My name is still remaining the same, VJSados. Bye.